a really great first half. What fell away for you in the second half?
I thought the first probably 10 or 15 minutes we didn't handle as well as we would have liked. I thought they had a pretty fast start on us, and I think we turned the footy over, and then a 7-tackle set. So we put a fair bit of fatigue and pressure on ourselves. But I think to sum up, rather than just sit here and go straight to what was wrong, you know, other than the scoreboard, it's a pretty bloody good performance. So it's a pretty shitty way to start it.
KP, your thoughts on, obviously there's a play in the second half where you go through and look for Gagai, just ball just a little bit too low. Is that your read on it?
Yeah, that's exactly what happened, yeah. Would have liked that moment back for sure.
Adam, they said on Fox that you wanted more kick pressure on Drinkwater. Were you happy with that in the second half?
It wasn't kick pressure, it was our kick chase line. We left too many pockets through the middle third of the field, and you could see the wingers wanted to... We'll send him down a four-man kick chase line. We needed a thicker line on him. I thought he was quite dangerous through that part of the field. That's what I was talking about.
Was it better in the second half?
Somewhat, yeah. I think we actually tidied it up before half-time. We started to get a thicker line down there on him, but, yeah.
Looks like you had a few bumps and bruises.
Is
that just the point in the season, or is there anything more to it?
It's a tough game. It's a tough game we play. Tough opposition, semi-finals footy. It's the beauty of it, isn't it? It's fast, it's hard. Momentum shifts. I thought we were in it till the end there.
Adam, what was your message to the guys after that?
After the game?
Yeah.
Yeah, look, it's never nice losing a finals game, but I think over time we can sit back and look at a season that, I don't know, we were gritty and tough all year. There was plenty of times, plenty of things said about us, you know, no one really gave us much of a chance, and we managed to stick together, united and fought. Now, I thought we did that tonight. I don't think the scoreboard's a reflection of the effort and the fight that's in this team, and they're good traits to have as a footy team and as men, as, you know, fathers and husbands and all the things that these guys have got going on. They're good values to have if you've got resilience and grit and ability to fight through tough periods, whether it's games or tough periods of your season. They've done that. So I just feel like we've turned the corner a fair bit in terms of our DNA. Yeah, we want to be sitting here talking about a win, but it's not through lack of having a go.
Would you like to see the team, like in the future, like have better starts to your season? Like you've shown a lot, like you said, you've shown a lot of grit and fight 2 years in a row now.
Yeah.
And other years to come back
from
the dead almost to get yourself here. But how can you change? What do you reckon about going forward?
Yeah, well, ideally you don't want to put yourself in a position where you've got to win every game at the back end, but some of it with us has been to do with didn't have him for 11 weeks, and you saw what he did out there tonight. So there's a few things that play a part in what happens in your season, and having him, I don't know, everyone says, oh, we rely on him a lot, but we had other guys like Bradman, and we were missing a chunk of some high quality player at the start of the year, so we had to manage our way through that. I think we had a pretty tough draw at the start too, in terms of travel. It was a long time ago, but anyway, we didn't cave in. We kept fighting, so we're here tonight. You know, there's plenty of other teams that finished last week.
What about like next year, Adam, and just bad spiders on him tonight. Did everything he could for his team.
Yeah, he gets a lot of reps. He probably doesn't get enough raps for how tough he is and how committed he is. You know, there's always something or an agenda written about the Knights or about him, but the way he spoke to his teammates in there and how proud he was of the performance tonight and our season, you know, speaks volumes for him. He's our captain for a reason, and he leads by example out there, and I know he's athletic and fast and brings plenty of young children watch our game because of him, but he's so much more than that too, as a human being and a player to us.
You feel like you're on the up, Adam, into the future now, like this club, like you've made the finals nearly every year you've been there. Do you feel like you've got another gear to really challenge for a title in the years ahead?
Well, I hope so, yeah. We're not content. Like, we're proud that we're in finals, but that's not we're not content with that either. Like, don't get me wrong, we're in here talking pretty positive, and I don't think tonight's a night for us to dive into searching for answers to why we got beat. But we're not content with just 1 week in finals. We want to, as an organisation and a club, and make some decisions, and everything each day that we do is about trying to bring success to Newcastle. We love to win a premiership, and it takes time and it takes a lot of effort, and you've got to stick at it. So yeah, we're on the path, we've just got to stay on it, and hopefully we can get there.